Hey guys, I want to talk to you a little bit about the chaos that's been going on today about World War II zombies. But first, I want to let you know that I've updated my phone app. It is on Android and iOS devices. On the bottom right, you can see World War II zombies. If you click on that, you can see the tutorials. So if you guys want to check that out, I'll have the links down in the description. Also, I was able to get 5 of these Juggernog bottle openers. This is a brand new product from Call of Duty. It's an official merchandise, and I'll be giving away 5 of them. If you guys go to my website, it's just on the main page, glitchingqueen.com. Just scroll down and you can enter the giveaway. I'll be emailing the winners and also announcing it on my Twitter. Okay, so we know Call of Duty World War II is coming out next Friday, and we know that people have been able to get their hands on early copies. In fact, one early copy got sold on eBay, and here's the listing right here. It sold on October 26th. The person said that they had it on hand, sold it for $300. This listing was only up for a few minutes and it sold really, really quickly. So yes, the copies have started to sell. And as of yesterday, we found out that people actually got them in hand. And when they went to go to try to play it, they got a message that popped up that said they couldn't play it, that there's got to be some kind of a patch update to allow the game to unlock and play it. And when this news started to surface, a lot of us were really excited. We're like, wow, that's really smart of Sledgehammer and Activision to lock a game down, not make it available to play until the release day. At least that's what we thought. So we all went to bed Saturday night happy, thinking that, yeah, there's not going to be any major leaks. It's going to be fair. We're all going to get to play it at the same time, you know, when it's released. But no, we woke up today with a patch that actually made this game now playable. So here we're thinking that, you know, they've made a really smart move and they're ahead of the game and they're gonna protect the game and, you know, protect the players and allow it to be fair for everyone. But apparently that's not what was going on. And I'm not sure about the technical side of things of like, why couldn't they just like not release this patch until the game was ready? Like, I don't know anything about that and, you know, what's going on behind the scenes at their office, and we'll never know that answer. But what I do know is today was like an explosion of leaks. I mean, you pretty much had to stay away from the internet to avoid them. They were everywhere and like all over Reddit. Charlie Intel was tweeting them left and right. And that's something that's happened before, you know, people get early copies, they play, you know, they leak the game footage. But this time it was a little bit different because people were solving lots of Easter eggs and posting it everywhere. And I don't know how much this is going to hurt the game or not, and I'm not going to give you guys any spoilers. I'm just going to kind of talk to you about what happened in the community today, and there's probably just a little bit of hope left for this map, but who knows? The next few days are going to be really critical. At first, the leak started out pretty tame and, you know, what you'd expect, you know, somebody just running around the map showing things, and, you know, we weren't expecting a whole lot. Then all of a sudden, it was like all these images being posted about lots of Easter eggs and people being very successful with them. And this is definitely unheard of and very new for like the COD community to have these things solved 5 days before the game's even out. I know me and my friends, we were looking forward to this Easter egg hunt. You know, it's kind of a community effort. Everybody goes in at the same time at the starting line, and it's kind of a race, and, you know, it's fun. It brings people together, and people get to claim first in the world and stuff like that. And when we found out today some of the stuff that went down, like, we were sad. We were like, this is bad, you know? You know, we were really just upset, but then things may have turned around a little bit, and I'll explain that some. So I had made a video like last week about the trophies that were released, and one of them at the top, Call Fireworks, is a silver trophy, and that is the one that was uncovered today. So we were thinking that this is part of the main Easter egg. There's also a hidden trophy right below it. I won't go over that. I went over it in another video, and some of you guys don't want spoilers, so I'm not going to talk about it. But that has not been uncovered yet. So that's giving us a little bit of hope. So that first trophy was definitely earned pretty quickly. I can tell you that the person that did it very fast. And they also did a lot of other things in that amount of time as well. And it was their first playthrough. I will tell you that the current status is that everybody is on a standstill as far as what to do next. I don't think anybody knows. And if they do know, they're probably not telling. So let's hope that when this game releases at the end of the week, that trophy is still locked. And some people might be able to just, like, deal with it in a way of, well, I won't look at the leaks and I'll just play it and, you know, figure it out on my own. But there's definitely some excitement there whenever you do get a new game and there isn't an Easter egg solved yet. It's, like, brand new and everybody in the world's going after it. It's fair and it's fun. And this way, it's not fair. So what I'm hoping for is that, yes, this second trophy does not get uncovered and we all have a shot at it. And hopefully there's a lot of, like, little side Easter eggs. And let's hope that this Easter egg is really tough. Because from what I'm hearing, the first one is very guided. And that's why it got solved so very, very quickly. And the guy that solved it, he had said that he gives this game about a 7.5 out of 10. He says the creep factor is definitely an 11 out of 10. It's very, very creepy. But yes, this next week is going to be really interesting. They've got several days to figure out a lot of Easter eggs, and it's probably going to be exploited all over Reddit and by Charlie Intel. So we'll just hang in there and stay positive. You know, there might be a lot of other little hidden things that we don't know about. So definitely don't give up. I'm not going to give up. I'm still just going to, you know, keep my head up and make videos and just enjoy playing zombies. Also, Activision is doing a pretty good job of taking down footage, but there is a whole bunch of stuff on Reddit right now that's still sitting there, so I'm not too sure what they're gonna do about that this week. Hopefully they'll be on top of it, and it'll be interesting to see what the developers have to say about this, if they are, you know, gonna say something publicly on Twitter about all of this and how they might plan on handling it. Definitely let me know what you guys think about this, and we'll see you next video.